Hey there, you're watching Amitha Verma.
Today I wanted to share a really quick styling session with you. A lot of times builders will build in 1 to 2 bookshelves in a kitchen, and many of us are just at a loss on how do we use them. So come along with me today as I share with you exactly how I would style 2 bookshelves that you would often find in a kitchen. So I'm standing next to a very pretty antique bookshelf or bookcase in my store, Village Antiques, and I'm going to use this today to demonstrate to you how exactly I would style 2 shelves. Use your imagination and just envision that these 2 shelves are something like you would find in your kitchen. This might be over a cooktop or over your buffet or over a serving area. When you're styling a kitchen or really any bookshelf, there's 3 elements I want you to remember. 1 is color, the 2nd is consistency, and the 3rd is repetition. These are the reasons why your bookshelves don't look good. You want to have these 3 elements over and over and over again, even if you're just working with 2 shelves. You want to see the same colors over again, you want to see consistency in the type of materials or objects that you're putting on your shelves, and you want to see repetition, which will bring that consistency and color back into your shelves over and over again. So the first thing that I like to do is start in 1 corner of my shelf and then work my way down. One of my favorite design tricks for any set of bookshelves is to add paintings into the back of your bookshelves. They create such beautiful depth and dimension and really bring that color into your project. So whenever I'm looking for paintings, if I'm working on a bookshelf project, let's say I'm working on 2 shelves, I want to look for anywhere from 2 to 3 paintings. I know that may sound like a lot, but again, we want to have that consistency and repetition. And I'm going to start in 1 corner and sort of offset it. So it's not going to be to the center, it's not going to be to the left or all the way to the right. It could be all the way to the right, but I'm going to select a corner and start here, and we're going to start staggering our objects in a sort of zigzag pattern. So I'm gonna use this art easel actually to prop my painting up so it'll stand up kind of free floating into my bookshelves. Now I'm gonna move on to really filling in this bookshelf so you can see how this zigzag pattern I'm referring to is going to come to play. Now when you're looking for objects to add into your kitchen, really just think about the things that you love. And if you don't know what you love, think about the things that you don't love and then use the process of elimination to get rid of the options that may not work for your home. I love to use objects such as creamware, pewter, crystal, transferware, and once I decide which one of those I want, I like to use that key element I told you, repetition, and look for those items to repeat on this shelf and then again on the next shelf. The first thing I like to do is to look for something kind of in a taller height range. And then I like to look for something a little bit lower, contrast a little bit. And as I'm moving down, I want to create some movement with my pieces. So the movement is sort of tall, small, and then medium. So the next thing I'm going to do is move on to the opposite corner. Now when I refer to that zigzag pattern I like to use, I'm looking at this corner and I want to offset to create balance onto this corner. And I personally like to repeat what I have used up here. So I'm going to look for another painting and preferably something not matching. I want to really create pockets of interest and visual beauty, and I don't want you to feel like if you've seen one thing, you've seen everything. Now on this corner, what I like to use are really my cookbooks. If you've got cookbooks that are very bright and colorful, as cookbooks usually are because they want the food to be tempting and inviting, a good design tip I can suggest to you is just to remove the dust jackets. And if you just really want it to be gorgeous, you're not really interested in adding cookbooks, you can put together your favorite assortment of design books, or you can just go to a shop like Village Antiques and look for beautiful antique ledger books or leather bound books and look for the colors that go with your interiors. If you're not going to be accessing your books very often, a really pretty tip that you could do is to take your next piece of creamware and arrange it right here on top of your book. So there you can see visually it sort of fills in this creamware design but it's not repeating what you've already seen above. Now the reason why I selected this tureen is because I want to have variety in the dimensions of the pieces that I'm putting in my bookshelves. So we already have this rhythm going on of tall, small, medium. So I don't really want to repeat that with another set of pitchers or vases because we've already seen that. And for my finishing touches, I love to include small containers where I can just pop in a few quick fresh flowers and leave it there so I could just be, have a little reminder to pop in a few fresh flowers whenever I get the opportunity. So I know you're thinking, Amitha, you told me you love to use transferware and pewter, and how and where can I put those things? So basically, this arrangement is sort of my template. And if you look at the sketch that I've made, you can see this is the template that I use on all of my bookshelf projects whenever I'm working in a kitchen. And the way you can interchange the things that you like are by, for instance, if you love transferware, you can easily interchange the backdrop that I've used with these paintings with transferware. So you can see how easily I can change this bookshelf design just by interchanging a couple of the elements in my template, so to speak. So there you can see how quickly I was able to style these two shelves as if they were in a kitchen. So just remember my key three elements: repetition, consistency, and color. Remember I showed you how you want to have a variety in your heights and your dimension so you can tell a very beautiful story and have gorgeous movement all throughout your bookshelf. I hope you've enjoyed today's styling session guide. This is one of my favorite projects to do, and now that you have the know-how and the knowledge on how to do it for yourself, get started on your project. If you've enjoyed this video, please leave a comment and definitely share with a friend. Thank you so much, and I look forward to seeing you around the shop soon.